All right, everyone. This is a brand new build. I'm not really sure what it'll be, but I want to do just a crazy scratch build, just bashing together everything on this table here into something. So let's play around and see what we can come up with. I went into my other model box that has all these extra parts. Found these for a small Enterprise warp engines. So I'm going to use this as the neck. Go from here to the primary hull. I was kind of thinking maybe using these for the neck, but they're a little bit too short. And I got these here. This here is from an old Excelsior model. I'm going to use that as the bridge dome. And this was from my 350 scale Klingon bridge. I cut it down a little bit and I put it underneath here as part of the navigational deflector, or something will go there. Don't know yet. Because I got all these extra parts here and I got a bunch of extra parts here. 350 scale Klingon build. A bunch of other little bits and knickknacks that you just put on, like for hull decoration or something like that. I found a second warp nacelle. So there'll be two warp nacelles. I'll put them on this here, one on either side there. These will have to be cut off. Okay, first thing I'm going to do now with these and that and the warp nacelles here is I'm going to spray silver on the insides to prevent any light bleed through. These dry overnight, and then I'll be cutting the arms off all the warp engines because I won't need those for this build, and then we can move on to the next step. listen here. I got a lot of filling to do here. A little bit here. So anyway, let's find out where we want to put these. On here. So, you know, normally where the other Klingon warp engines went, I want to put them on here. So, have like, kind of like this look to it. Okay, so I decided to put this arm on. So I went and got my model of the Klingon ship so I can get the proper dimensions to make a part for either side here. And then the warp engine will go on the arm there. We're using this to get the proper angle for the back here. So it's a 51 degrees. And again, for the front, which I come up with. Now I just need to measure from there down to here to get the bottom. There we go. Now I just need to make three more of those. Alright, got all of those, but I'm not done yet. I need to get the edges here now, front and back. So what I gotta do is that's 6 millimeters wide, but then the edge of that is 1 millimeter, so I just need to make it 4 millimeters all the way down front and back. Okay, now I got the inside edges here, the long ones, the short ones, and these here are the lips that go down inside here like this that slide down into the warp nacelles. I'll cut a little groove in here for the wiring that'll go up into the main body or down, whatever. So this is like the tongue that fits down into the warp engine, just like there's a tongue here that fits down into this. Alright, I'm going to start with the tugs here. Pretty big, which is good. And I made it like this, where it curves straight down. Like this part here that goes straight down goes into the warp engine. So something like that. Here. not need to worry about the, I'm not going to worry about putting a notch in there, because it's, more than wide enough. Alright. Okay. That is on there. It ain't coming off. Need to make adjustments on any part, just reheat the glue. Don't put any extra glue down, just use the glue gun itself to heat it up, and then you can reposition. Just like that. Alright, I had to take these off on that side, because that side goes to the main body. That's what happens when you try to go too fast without thinking ahead. So now this, goes on that side, and this one goes on the other side. Alright, so all glued in place there, got the hole there for the wiring. Looks good. Not bad. There we go. Not too bad. Looks good. Right on. That's it for this episode, everyone. And the next one, we're going to be starting on the primary hull and getting that with the neck. So, please like, subscribe, comment. And if you have any questions or you want me to do some commission work for you, please contact me at modelbuilding501@yahoo.ca. And don't forget to check out my online store. The link is down below.